Hello everyone! Welcome to Lesson 44 Grammar Explanation. And before proceeding to this video, make sure to watch the Lesson 44 Vocabulary video so that you'll understand the words that we will use for today's lesson. Dewa, hajimimashou!
Janjal-san, kyo wa hayaku kaerimasu. Saki ni isri shimasu.
Doushita desu ka?
Kino gounen kai de osaki o nomi sugite atama ga itain desu.
それはいけませんね。薬はもう飲みましたか？
いいえ、まだです。
じゃあ、この薬は飲みやすいから飲んでください。
ありがとうございます。
These are our topics for today. Let's discuss grammar point number one, the verb minus mas.Plus sugimasu, the e adjective sugimasu, and the na adjective sugimasu. The sugimasu indicates that the extent of an action or state is excessive and is therefore usually used when that action or state is undesirable. So saying that doing something excessively and it is undesirable. Let's read example number one. Yube osake o nomi sugimashita.From the verb osake o nomimasu, to drink wine. So yube, last night, osake o nomi plus sugimashita. Remove masu from the verb nomimasu and add sugimashita. It means that I drank too much and that action is excessive or undesirable. Example number two, kono seta wa oki sugimasu. So from the e adjective oki.So remove i and add sugimasu. It means it's too big, it's excessive, and undesirable. This sweater is too big for me. And for the na adjectives, example number 3, saikin no kuruma wa sousa ga kantan sugite unten ga omoshiroku nai desu. So saikin no kuruma, the recent cars or modern cars, sousa means operation.Sousa ga kantan desu. Kantan means easy. Then kantan sugite, it's too easy. Too easy. It's undesirable. Too easy for me. Kantan sugite. Then he said, unten ga omoshiroku nai desu. Unten means driving. So omoshiroku nai desu, it's not fun. Because the operation or they are easy to drive. The modern cars are easy to drive.Sousa ga kantan sugite. Example number 4. Ikura suki demo nomisugiru to karada ni warui desu yo. Ikura suki demo. No matter how much you like it, nomisugiru to, if you drink too much, so from nomisugimasu, then nomisugiru to, the to pattern. If something will happen, something will also happen. Inevitably. So nomisugiru to, if you drink too much,Karada ni warui desu yo, it's bad for your health. So when you're describing something or saying something that is excessive and it's undesirable or it is too much, we will use the pattern sugimasu. Grammar point number 2, the verb minus mas, yasui desu, and the verb minus mas, nikui desu. When the verb minus mas form is a volitional verb,Adding yasui means that it is easy to carry out the action indicated by the verb. And adding nikui means that it is difficult to carry out. Example number 5. Kono pasokon wa tsukai yasui desu. From the verb tsukaimasu means to use tsukaimasu. Kono pasokon wa tsukaimasu, to use this personal computer.Remove mas, add yasui, it means that it is easy to use. Tsukai yasui. Tsukai yasui desu. Example number 6. We will add nikui to the verb to indicate that the action indicated by the verb is hard to carry out or hard to do. So example number 6. Tokyo wa sumi nikui desu. So from the verb sumimasu means to live. Tokyo wa sumi nikui desu. It's hard to live in Tokyo.When the verb minus mas form is a non-volitional verb, adding yasui means that the action indicated by the verb is likely to occur or it's likely to happen. While adding nikui means that the action indicated by the verb is unlikely to occur. Example number 7, shiroi shatsu wa yugori yasui desu. So shiroi shatsu, white shirt, wa yugori yasui desu, from the verb yugorimasu, means to get dirty. Then yugore yasui desu means it's easy to get dirty. Yugore yasui desu. Example number 8, ame no hi wa sentaku mono ga kawaki nikui desu. So ame no hi wa, on rainy days, sentaku mono ga kawaki nikui desu. From the verb kawakimasu means to dry. So sentaku mono means laundry, ga kawaki nikui desu, doesn't dry easily. From the verb kawakimasu, to dry. So adding nikui to the verb kawakimasu means it's unlikely to occur or hard to happen, not easy to happen. So adding yasui and nikui decline like adjectives. So yasui and nikui are like adjectives when you conjugate them to other forms like te forms or negative forms of adjectives. Example number 9, kono kusori wa sato o ireru to nomi yasuku narimasu yo. So kono kusori wa, this medicine, sato o ireru to, if you add sugar, nomi yasuku narimasu. From nomimasu, to drink, nomi yasui, easy to drink, then nomi yasuku narimasu becomes easy to drink. This is a pattern of our previous lessons, the e-adjective narimasu. And example number 10, kono koppu wa warinikou kote anzen desu yo. Kono koppu wa, this cup, warinikui desu. Warinikui, from the verb warimasu, to break. Then warinikui, hard to break. And warinikou kote, our previous lessons, the verb te. This is a reason, because it's hard to break, anzen desu yo, it is safe, or it's safe to use. Grammar point number 3, noun o adjective ni, or noun ni shimasu. So on our previous lessons, in lesson 19, we learned the e adjective narimasu and the na adjective narimasu. It expresses a change in the subject of a sentence using the adjective narimasu. In this lesson, the adjective plus shimasu indicates changing its object. Changing its object. Example number 11. Oto wo okiku shimasu. Oto wo okiku shimasu. Oto means sound. Particle o. Okiku shimasu. So from the adjective oki means big. So using the adjective oki to the object oto or sound means the volume. Okiku shimasu. You are the one to make the volume up, oki or big. So referring to the volume of the sound. The adjective oki plus shimasu, remove i, add ku, then shimasu. Okiku shimasu. Example number 12, heya o kirei ni shimasu. So this is a na adjective. So before shimasu, we will add particle ni. Kirei ni shimasu. Heya o, my room. Heya o kirei ni shimasu. The adjective is kirei, clean, plus shimasu, it means that you will change the heya, you will change the room, you will make it clean, kirei ni shimasu. Example number 13, shio no ryo o hanbun ni shimashita. So shio no ryo, the amount of salt, o hanbun ni shimashita. So hanbun ni shimashita, shimashita, I made the quantity of the salt hanbun, half. Hanbun ni shimashita. Grammar point number 4, noun ni shimasu. This sentence pattern indicates a choice or decision. So noun ni shimasu, I'm choosing this noun. Let's read example number 14. Heya wa shinguru ni shimasu ka? Twin ni shimasu ka? So choosing between the two. Shinguru ni shimasu ka? Twin ni shimasu ka? So shinguru means single room. Ni shimasu ka? Will you choose the single room? Twin ni shimasu ka? Or you will choose the twin room? So you can answer shinguru ni shimasu, I'm choosing the single room, or twin ni shimasu, I'll choose the twin. And example number 15, kaigi wa ashita ni shimasu. Kaigi wa ashita ni shimasu. Once again, this sentence pattern indicates a choice or decision. So decision making. So making a decision. Kaigi wa ashita ni shimasu. will be having the meeting tomorrow. So it's a decision that the meeting will be held tomorrow. Ashita ni shimasu. And that's all for this lesson, guys. Make sure to visit our online textbook at manabotextbook.com so you can access our free exercises and example sentences about today's lesson. We've also made lecture videos to make it easier for you to understand the contents of our online textbook. Minasan, kyo no lesson wa ikaga deshita ka? I hope you learned a lot in today's lesson. If you have questions, you can leave a comment below, and also you can follow me on my Instagram account. Please subscribe to our channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss our future lessons. Dewa, mata ne. Bye-bye.